Hello everyone, I'm Sujata Kuprajum, Solutions Architect with AWS. I'm joining with my peers Shiva Rajamani and Christopher Sharkey to talk about the approach to visualize AWS Security Hub findings using Amazon QuickSight. AWS Security Hub provides you with a comprehensive view of your security state within AWS and your compliance with security standards and best practices. Security Hub centralizes and prioritizes security findings from across AWS accounts, services, and supported third-party partners to help you analyze your security trends and identify the highest priority security issues. Findings are summarized on integrated dashboards with graphs, charts, and tables to help you easily identify potential issues and take the necessary next steps. In addition to built-in dashboards, customers like to connect Security Hub findings with their existing operational data store and build visualizations using Amazon QuickSight to make data-driven decisions. A couple of use cases are connecting Security Hub findings with AWS CloudTrail logs to get deeper insights, and even connecting AWS resources metadata with Security Hub findings and build security and compliance scorecard. There are four main steps involved to view Security Hub findings with Amazon QuickSight. Initial two steps are setting up Security Hub administrator account and enabling Security Hub in member accounts. Let us see how to do that. Connect to your management account and set up a delegated administrator for Security Hub. This account is granted access to view findings for associated member accounts. From your Security Hub administrator account, choose member accounts and select the aggregation region. This is the region in which you can manage, view, and manage findings. Make sure to enable Security Hub in your member accounts for regions you are operating. Once Security Hub is enabled in member accounts and findings are gathered, you can view the consolidated findings from the admin account and aggregation region. Now let me hand over to Shiva to explain the approach to export consolidated findings.
Now that you have Security Hub configured with an administrator account and an aggregation region to consolidate your findings, the next step is to export the findings into a central location for dashboarding and visualization. AWS Security Hub automatically sends all new findings and all updates to existing findings to EventBridge as EventBridge events. Each event contains a single finding. You can define rules in EventBridge that automatically routes findings to an Amazon S3 bucket. The solution approach creates an EventBridge rule in the Security Hub administrator account and in the aggregation region with Amazon Kinesis Data Firehose as a target for the EventBridge rule to automatically deliver the Security Hub findings to a S3 bucket. Amazon Kinesis Data Firehose is a fully managed service for delivering data into data stores, data lakes, and analytic tools. With Kinesis Data Firehose, you configure your data producers to send data to Kinesis Data Firehose, and it automatically delivers the data to the destination that you specify, in this case, the S3 bucket. Let us see how to configure the EventBridge rule with Amazon Kinesis Data Firehose as target to export the findings into S3 bucket within AWS Management Console. I have already created the Amazon S3 bucket and also the IAM role with permissions for Kinesis Data Firehose to write to the S3 bucket. Let's now navigate to Kinesis console to create the Firehose delivery stream. For source, choose direct put. For destination, Amazon S3. Provide a name for the delivery stream. Keep the settings default for transform and convert records. Under the destination settings, choose the S3 bucket created for storing the Security Hub findings by clicking on the browse button and searching for the bucket name. Under the advanced settings, for the permissions, I have chosen the existing IAM role that I have created already. Create the delivery stream. It can take up to 5 minutes for the created delivery stream to be available. The status will show as active once created. The next step is to create an EventBridge rule for the Security Hub findings. For this, let's navigate to the EventBridge console. Provide a name for the rule. Under the Define Pattern section, choose Event Pattern. For the Event Matching Pattern, choose Predefined Pattern by Service. The service provided to be AWS, service name as Security Hub, and event type as Security Hub Findings Imported. Under the Target section, choose Firehose Delivery Stream. and choose the stream that was created in the previous step. Create the rule. Now that the Event Bridge rule is created, after a few minutes, you can validate the Security Hub findings are exported to the S3 bucket by checking the contents of the S3 bucket. With the Security Hub findings now available in the S3 bucket, the next step is to create dashboards for visualization. For that, I will turn this over to Chris to cover the steps involved.
Let's look at how we can visualize the results and insights that are generated by AWS Security Hub. As Siva showed you, the findings that Security Hub have are stored in Amazon S3 as a gzip JSON file. Our end goal is to be able to build dashboards against the data that's inside of S3. We build these dashboards using Amazon QuickSight. QuickSight, however, has a few pieces before it that help it process this JSON data. Specifically, we use Amazon Athena in combination with the Glue Data Catalog and the Glue Crawler to be able to easily consume the insights that are generated by AWS Security Hub and are placed in our S3 bucket by Kinesis Data Firehose. Let's take a look at this in the AWS console. I'm now at the AWS console. Siva showed us in the previous slide that we had JSON data in our S3 bucket, and that those were the findings from our Security Hub. We can begin our process by going to AWS Glue. Within Glue, I've created a crawler. We can view the details of the crawler here. And this crawler is set to crawl or look at the log data that's been generated. The crawler generates a Glue metadata table, which you can see here. The primary benefit of running the crawler is the generation of this metadata, or essentially the specifics of the schema of the insights that are generated by Security Hub. You can notice in particular we have this detail column, and within that there's a more complex JSON structure that has lots of useful information. Generating this Glue data catalog table from that crawler, which I showed you, allows us to come to AWS Athena. Athena gives us the ability to easily query data within S3. You can see that I have here the table that was generated by the crawler. We can run a query on that table and take a look at the data. You'll see that we have useful information such as the account, the time, the region. However, we have this one field in particular, resource, which has a lot of sub-properties to it and lots of useful information. Ideally, we want to flatten this JSON array into a structure that's easier to query. There's multiple ways to do this, including in the Kinesis Data Firehose, a Lambda function that can automatically do this. Or in my case, what I've done is I've used some built-in functions in Athena for processing JSON to flatten that structure. I've used SQL and created a view here. You could see the view present here. I've named it Security Hub. When I query this view, what you'll see is we have all of the columns from before, but in addition, we have many extra columns, such as product ARN, type, so on and so forth. And again, what this is the SQL query inside of the view is breaking down that JSON in the details column of the original table. Now that the data is easy to query, we can come to QuickSight. I have already created a data set in QuickSight that's connected to that Athena table, or view I should say, that I just showed you. And really from here, it's quite straightforward to build a nice dashboard where we can take a look at all different kinds of insights. You'll see here I have all of these different columns available. These are the columns that I parsed out in the view. And just to give you an example, I have some filters up top. I can filter on resource type, region, account. And as an example here, I have findings by severity. We can see that we have 38 high severity, 28 medium. From this point on, QuickSight can be used to easily generate all kinds of visuals.
The approach that we showed here uses multiple AWS services such as Amazon Event Bridge, Amazon S3, Amazon Kinesis Data Firehose, AWS Glue, and Amazon Athena, along with AWS Security Hub and Amazon QuickSight. So when you perform cost estimation to build this solution, consider pricing factors and price calculation for all services included in this design. In this video, we showed you an approach to visualize AWS Security Hub findings using Amazon QuickSight. Exporting Security Hub findings to a centralized repository, connecting with operational data, and making them searchable will allow you to draw meaningful insights, which in turn help you achieve an improved organization-wide security posture. Thank you.